All right, y'all. We finally got some time off of work, so I'm gonna show y'all how to paint this old fish today. First thing you need is some newspaper. What we're gonna do, we're gonna pull this ink off of this newspaper and transfer it onto these scales, giving an antiquing effect on it. So get this all rolled up. We're just gonna lay that on our fish. I don't know if y'all can see that, but it gives them scales some detail, like it pulls them up off the form. And we'll take some 4-aught steel wool, just lightly hit that. Kind of hitting all them high spots. All right. Now, second thing we're going to do is some Payne's gray. And we're going to go above this lateral line, darken this all up. All right, we're going to lay this to the other side. Now we'll take our steel wool again and kind of buff this real lightly. Thank you. Get all the dark spots. You want pretty uniform. See how it makes them scales pop out of there? Alright. Now, we're going to take our lacquer thinner, put a little on a Q-tip, and on these fins, we're going to just kind of streak that. And we'll leave some of that on there, that way it brings out some detail in them fins. Next step. All right, y'all, now it's time for some color. We're going to take a watercolor pencil, about probably a yellow chrome. We're going to take this and just start scribbling this on the back. It looks crazy, I know, but it works. Right above that lateral line. We'll take us a paper towel. There. I'm going to take the green and go below the lateral line. It may not come up on camera, but if you walk up on this fish and turn it, you'll be able to see it. All right, y'all. We got our iridescent on there. We're going to hit this with a light coat of clear coat. I'm gonna warm this surface up, but hit this just to lock them colors on. Hit it with the hairdryer again. Thank you. With that finished drying, we'll move on to the next step. Alright. Now we're going to start our bars. This is just the first layer of our bars on here. We're going to take this charcoal about right where this dorsal fin starts. That's about where your lines is on a fish. It's always good to have good reference pictures when you're doing this. That way you can match your fish or somebody's fish, whoever's fish it is. So we're just going to come in here and kind of make some patterns. Now that you got a pattern, you know, come in here and just kind of diffuse that. Once you get a pattern you like, now we got one that comes in at an angle above that, this gill plate. Get that one in there. We're going to put a light line all the way around this. Now we'll diffuse it. Kind of gives your bars an outline. All right, y'all, now that that's dry, we're going to take some blue iridescent. We're going to go in between these bars. I'll finish this up and then we'll be back. Alright y'all, now I got my airbrush working again. We're gonna come across this bike with some emerald green. Now what we'll do, we got a green on, we're going to take this fine charcoal, we're just going to hit some vermiculations on our stripes now, add another layer. Now, we'll just kind of feather that out a little. Take some lacquer thinner. Go in between them. Okay, y'all. We got a green on. Now we're going to do some scale tipping. This is a lengthy process, but I'll show you all how we start, and then I'll go ahead and finish it up. Take some green. Come right in here on these scales. Just start tipping them. I'll finish this up and we'll be back. Alright y'all, so I scale tip with the green and the gold. Let's see if I can get that in there. Anyway, headed on to the next step. Now that our scales are dry, we're going to take this tape, we're going to mask off this lower mandible and gill cover. Now we're going to come in here with True Blue and put the blue in there. True Blue. Clear coat again. And we'll clear coat that. Now that your blue's dry, you can come in here on this gill cover. Bring your line out. This is tough trying to video this and paint at the same time. There's one layer. Alright, now we can put the candy panes of gray on. Frame the head out. Hopefully y'all can see that. Now we can come in here with our vermiculations and dress them up a little bit more. All right, y'all, now she's nice and dry. We're gonna take her tape off and then we're gonna put it on this side. We're fixing to brighten this belly up. Ah, so what we're gonna do now, we're gonna take some bright yellow. We're gonna hit this breast area with it. And we're gonna make orange. With this and gill red. In a minute. Get a red now. Gill red. Now we got the orange. Now we're going to take a watercolor pencil and we're just going to highlight some of these scales right on the edge. Now I got those scales in there. We're going to take solar gold. We're going to go over this whole area here. Now, we're going to pull the tape off. We're going to put some color in between our spots, stripes now. We're going to use this solar gold. Take the finger. Just another layer of color. Same process. And we're going to lock that down. Then on to the next step. We're going to take the iridescent green, do our belly section. Alright y'all, we got our iridescent green locked down. I'm going to do some more scale tipping in between these bars and on this back. We'll be back for the next step. Alright y'all, got the scale detail all done. Hopefully you can start to see all the colors starting to show up now. That's why you start light. Build your paint color up. All right, we're going to start on the fins now. We're going to take some Candy Payne's Gray. Now we'll take our golden yellow and hit in between the fins. Candy paint's gray again. It's going to take us a little white. Go along this bin. Now we're going to clear gloss the fins. Alright y'all, well, we got the fin on there. All I got left to do is clear coat it. And I'll see y'all in just a second. Well, y'all, hopefully this looks like a bluegill to you. I hope y'all enjoy the video, and if you want to see more of them, we may do some more, but hopefully I put the video together pretty good. It took about 5 hours. I knew I wasn't going to put all that in the video, but hopefully you get the gist of it, and we'll see you in the next one. Thank you.